so I'm a car guy. I like to rebuild cars. With the help of SAS, we went from a 1969 Volkswagen to a 2022 Ferrari. We were doing things in Access databases, we were doing things in spreadsheets, and we were looking at small windows of the data just because of the capability we had, the machines we were running on. Now I can take the data from all 2.5 million flight hours for the C-130J and I can slice it and dice it and combine it in ways that were never possible before and at speeds that were never possible before. I can look at all the data that comes off the C-130J for a year's worth of flight in 30 seconds. So in the work we've been doing with SAS VIA, we've expanded our capabilities within fleet health monitoring to add in more sensor data, more causal events like hard landing or flying in the desert, flying in cold weather, things that can cause that failure to occur so that we can better provide information for CBM to say with more accuracy, this part's going to fail in the next 50 hours, 30 hours, 20 hours, so that they can then plan when that maintenance is going to occur instead of waiting for the failure to occur. It's enabling the customer to manage their maintenance, moving things from unscheduled to scheduled. It allows them to do their downtime when they want to do their downtime instead of having it happen randomly. I'm really excited about the future of what we can do with this partnership with SAS. My work in this kind of stemmed from a comment someone made to me when we started our partnership with SAS in 2014, and we were very focused at the time on the C-130J, when they told me I was trying to do fifth-gen sustainment on a first-gen aircraft. And they were right. It was a very first-gen aircraft, but there was data there that we didn't know we had access to, that we could pull more information off the aircraft. So now we're starting to do that. We're going to bring event stream processing onto the aircraft. We're going to feed that information down to the maintainer. He's going to have insights that he's never had before. The analytics that's going to sit behind the data that he sees now will be able to tell him things that he can go do, preparations he can make, ways to keep his pilots in the air, make sure that aircraft's not on the ground any second longer than it has to be. And now we'll start to expand that into other airframes that Lockheed Martin sells, F-35, F-22. How can we take what we've developed as far as machine learning, AI, and apply that to those platforms moving forward?